Hi there. In this video, we are going to talk about how can you do performance management. And we would try to keep this very short because performance management is interlinked with various other aspects of people management, as we stated before in my earlier video. So we're going to talk about the five tools that we are going to use for performance management. Yeah. And then out of those five tools, I'm going to just, you know, brief you guys in short about all of these tools. But some of these tool sets would be covered in a dedicated video later on, because that cannot be covered in one video, right? But let's talk about the five important tools of performance management. And they are feedback, appraisals, training, performance improvement plans, and employee engagement. And let me tell you that these are the five essential tools that you will have to use every single day in order to make sure that your team is performing at their natural best. Out of these five tools, we're going to have dedicated videos for feedback, appraisals, and employee engagement. So we're not going to talk about these three elements in detail in this particular video, but just to let you guys know that what we need to learn when it comes to feedback skills, yeah, is what are the right ways of giving feedback. Because as you know, that feedback is a very, very powerful tool. Feedback given to someone in the right way can transform that individual completely. And again, feedback given to the same individual in a wrong way can have devastating effects on that person and his performance. So what's the right way of giving feedback, how to give feedback, and what's the right time of giving feedback to an employee? Those skill sets we'll be learning in a completely different segments, where I'm going to target feedback as a dedicated training video. The next one is appraisals. As I stated before, that based on your organization's corporate policy, you will know your appraisal cycle. So most of the organization will have appraisal conducted once in a year, but now a lot of organizations are experimenting with their appraisal cycle. So a lot of organizations have quarterly appraisal cycle, semester wise appraisal cycle, and also annually. And some of the organizations have completely transformed their appraisal mechanism. Leading organizations like KPMG or Accenture, they have abolished the employee rating system at all. Yeah, so they're trying out new things. So with the changing generation and passing day and age, appraisals have come a long way. There are so many different methods by which you can conduct appraisals, and we're going to talk about those things in a dedicated video. Training. Now, this is, as I said, training or skill development. It's an integral part of performance management and people management. Not everybody in your team would be at the same skill level. So you will have to depend on training and skill development to make sure that your middle quartile and the lower quartile of the employees are getting those much required training, and they can perform better in future. So when it comes to training, you have to do a proper TNI. TNI is basically training need identification. Yeah. So what kind of training your team requires in order to be successful? So first you have to know what are the challenges, what are the weak links of the team, in which category your team is not doing well, or some of the people in your team are not doing well. What's blocking them in their performance? Why they're lacking in performance? And if the answer comes out in terms of they're lacking in skill set, then you have to understand that you need to trigger the training and skill development part of people management, yeah, in order to better the performance. So the training need identification has to be done right at the beginning. You also have to decide on when to impart the training. How many people can you accommodate in the training? in this pandemic COVID-19 situation, it has posed new challenges to the organization that you know, no more you are training people in a closed setup in a closed room. You possibly have to provide training virtually, and e-learning is a big deal now. Like how we are right now interacting on a YouTube platform, it's basically e-learning, right? So those things are posing new challenges to the training mechanism. You need to invest time on understanding on when to deliver the training. So let's say your employees are working in an 8 or 9 hour shift. Does your organization have the budget, have the training budget to make sure that out of those 8 or 9 hours, you can take out 1 hour every day for training, or 2 hours in a week for training? If that is the case, then your job is much more well defined and simple. You can take your guys out from your production hours and train them for those 2 hours. But if your organization is not very large sized or medium sized and they don't have much training budget, then it might mean that you will have to stretch after hours to train your weak performers, right? And for that, as I stated before, that do not announce your decision to the team. Ask the team that we need the training, and our organization does not have the budget at this point in time. So, but we still would need the training, because without the training, our performance will not improve, and their performance will not improve. And if their performance does not improve, not only in the appraisal, they get a poor rating, but also as an organization will not do well, as a team also will not do well. So what do you guys think that we should do? When can we do the training? Let the team member first come up with the ideas, brainstorm and give you ideas. Although you know at the back of your mind that you might have to stretch before working hours or after working hours to stay back for the training. Although you know that solution is in your mind, but as I stated before, do not tell it to the employee. First ask them, take their ideas. Maybe one of your employee might give you an idea which might be better than your presumed idea, and you might have to drop your idea for the better idea of your employee. So do give your employee a chance to speak up and cultivate their idea and solutions, and then see what's the best one. So if you think that your team is not able to come up with an idea, then you can propose your idea and see how the team reacts. How will you impart the training? When can you impart the training? That's also a decision that has to be made, and that's very crucial. And then once you provide the training, you need to have a follow-up done. You need to have a follow-up done maybe 1 week down the line or 1 month down the line, that post the training, how has the performance improved, or has it improved at all, right? So what's the impact of the training? That's also a thing that you have to consider, and for that you need to follow up with those people and with those people's performance, whether the training has a negative impact or a positive impact or no impact. And based on the follow-up, you might have to trigger a retraining, or you might have to trigger a performance improvement plan for the employee. Training is going to be an important element of performance management. So it's a very nice tool. So use it very wisely and make sure that you talk to your team and take their views into account when you're deciding the training timings and the training content. It has to be a need-based training. Yeah, it should not be training that you want to provide. It has to be a training that your team needs. Yeah, so the training need identification is very, very crucial. The fourth tool is performance improvement plan. As I stated before, that when you are giving feedback to an employee to improve his performance or behavior, when you're providing training to the employee for the same, but you will have a certain set of employees who are kind of laggards, and in spite of providing training to them, or in spite of providing multiple feedbacks, these employees might not show improvement in their performance or behavior. And as per the corporate policy, you might have to invoke a performance improvement plan. There again, different organizations, as per their policy, has different time periods for performance improvement plan. Some organization might give an employee chance to improve performance in 1 month. Some might give 3 months. Some might give 6 months, and some might give an extension for an year. But again, it depends on your organization and their corporate policy. But whenever you are putting someone in a performance improvement plan, you must ensure that you have a one-on-one discussion with the person in presence of the HR. It's imperative because the person should not feel that he is subjected to a punishment because of his poor performance and behavior. Rather, the person should feel that he is being given a helping hand from you, HR, and the organization to improve his performance. So the discussion that you're going to have should feature a lot of talks regarding what you need from us in order to improve your performance. Do you need training? Do you need feedback? Do you need any help, in your shift, in your timings, any personal thing going on in your family is bothering you? Those sort of discussion must happen. And the most important job responsibility of a manager would be to give the feeling to the employee that we are putting you under performance improvement plan because we care for you, and we want to give you an opportunity where we would want to put a lot of focus and undivided attention on you, give you training, give you all the things that you need to be successful so that you improve your behavior or performance and come out of this phase, yeah, and then become a very, very critical member of your team. Not that right now you are not, but if you fall behind, then our team falls behind. So the success of our team depends on your success. Yeah. So that kind of discussion should happen with an employee, which should give him or her the feeling that, hey, this is not a punishment that's coming my way, but this is just a helping hand that my manager and my organization is providing me, so that I can improve on my behavior or performance. Now, some of the organizations will also have mechanisms like warning letter in case the attitude or the behavior or escalation received is very severe on an employee. Yeah, so they might want to provide a warning letter straight away. And some organizations these days are very severe on ethics and integrity. So if you tend to violate the integrity and ethics of the corporate policy, then you might also get terminated straight away through a warning letter coming in from the HR. So that basically also comes under the performance improvement plan. However, a bit on the severe side. And again, once just coming back to the performance improvement plan, once you put an employee under the performance improvement plan, you must ensure that you have regular touch points with the person. You have regular follow-up. You keep asking the person, what do you guys need? Is everything going well? How is your performance now? So you keep a regular touch point. You monitor the performance. And if you see that the person is putting a genuine effort in order to improve his behavior or performance, do not ever, and I repeat this, do not ever miss out on a single instance where the person has shown you examples where he is trying to improve and shown improvements, even if the improvement is very small, but shown you signs of improvement in his behavior or performance. Do not ever, as a manager, miss a single instance where you are not motivating, cheering, and egging on the employee for those baby steps that he's taking or she's taking. Because do remember, when it comes to particularly behavior, it's very, very difficult to change one's behavior, right? But if a person is putting a genuine effort in order to improve his or her behavior, that basically means that he or she has realized the mistakes he has done, and they're trying to put a genuine effort. And when you try to put a genuine effort, you might succeed at the start or you might succeed at the end. But the moment you see signs of improvement, you must motivate, cheer, and egg on your team member so that he or she gets motivated and comes out of the performance improvement plan. And who knows, he can become your star performer next year. All right, so that's basically the fourth tool of performance management. And then we also have the fifth tool, that is employee engagement, a very critical tool. Without engaged people and engaged team members, you will never be able to achieve consistent performance, right? So it is such an important tool that I decided to put a completely dedicated video for employee engagement later on. So we're not going to spend a lot of time here. But all in all, these are the five tools that you have to play with in order to deal with performance management. And as I stated, regarding training or performance improvement plan, these are learnable skills, and you will only get better with practice. Yeah, you're just getting to know the theory part, but when you practice it every day, you will get better at it, and you will know a lot of new things, with the generation, this new generation into the workforce. You will have difficult times, providing feedback, doing appraisals, doing training need identification, doing performance improvement plan discussions, and doing those employee engagement activities. You will have challenges because, there are, two generations at play, the Generation X and the Millennials, and now the Centennials will also come in after 4 or 5 years. So you'll have a lot of challenges. But do remember that these are the five tools that you will always have to use in order to, do your performance management better. Hope you like the video, and I'll see you in the next video. Till that time, you take care and bye-bye.